Didn't expect to see this inside.
I do not see an exit either.
But there's something suspicious here.
I see two bird cages.
Looks like there's something inside them. Take a look.
A bird cage. There are ripped pieces of paper inside.
Let's do that and then try the most time consuming one.
All right, leave it to me. It is heavier than it looks.
Well, looks like we solved this lock by taking the left path.
Nothing happened.
All I did was move the cage.
Retry allow you to return to a save point just after unlocking a mental lock. You only have 3 retries, though. You regain 3 retries by selecting restart with the options button. This is likely your best option if time is low.
There are torn pieces of paper.
How about we piece them together?
Leave it to me.
Da 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 da.
Done. But
you were able to get out?
So the photo was the key. Remember it clearly. One day I came home to find that photo torn up in the trash can. When I asked her about it, she started to cry. Don't know why she tore it up, but whatever her reason, it seems like she regrets it. Since we repaired the photo in the Somnium, the birdcage...
Mizuki must be having a hard time.
But the cage is gone. We can get to Mizuki now.
Do you not see the horses spinning at hurricane speeds?
You can do it if you try a little.
No, you can't.
All right, fine. We have to stop the spinning.
The panda ride.
The panda head is spinning.
Spin more, stop, or ride. Ride. Huh? What? It's a horse.
A horse?
A horse?
Well, pandas and horses are pretty similar.
No, they're not!
They are completely different. Are you blind?
Yeah, well, they both have 5 letters.
How is that relevant?
That did nothing! Oh no! I'm gonna lose! What if we spin it more?
Bring it on!
Yeah!
Wait, stop. The centrifugal force is gonna tear it apart.
Do it!
I see. Spinning it makes it go faster.
How do we slow it down?
Okay, we just blew a bunch of time.
Spinning. 1 minute! Hurry!
Oh, fuck! I fucking hit the wrong button! Oh no, I've blown even more time! Oh no!
Time.
Let's try this again. I'll be right. I'll be back in a second. Hold on.
Actually, what button am I allowed to press here? Let's see. Yes, I can pick one of the two. I shall choose lock number 2. Bring me back when I had 90 plus seconds. It's okay. We don't even need to edit this shit. Yeah, remember this part? Classic moment in the video, right? Oh my god, I picked the wrong. Oh my god.
And toss them away. Ow.
Hey, handle them a little more carefully.
Oh my god, let me explain to you. I'm trying to select the thingies up there, the timies, right? And my natural inclination to scroll through things is to use the D-pad. You have muscle memory on a lot of things. That is fucked me on this day. Now, we're gonna put this to thirds. Do that.
Leave it to me.
We're gonna skip all this. Get us back over here. We're gonna mash this button like this. And then we're going to 1/8. Shit. We don't need it for this, though. At least stop the time. Or stop the panda. Aha!
I see. These were also linked.
That's right.
Mizuki!
Let's go to her.
Got it.
Okay, if you choose the correct answer as your final action, you can actually exceed the 360 time limit. Even if it seems like you don't have a lot of time left, don't give up. You might be able to do it. Here's sleep talking. More than 1 second. When you clear, you get a prize. No boss, anything but... Oh. You can spank it. You can ride it. I'm a ride this shit. Hold on. Makes time 1/8. Time to 40. What the fuck? That's a horrible one. We will do this, though. It's only going to be 5 seconds long. It might be funny.
Is it fun?
You all right?
Does it look fun?
You look cute like that.
Oh, I see.
Dante,
you're out of time.
I forgot to apply it, son of a bitch. Spank this horse.
Yeah.
You punched it?
Nothing is happening.
Poor horse.
A merry-go-round horse.
We have no time. Oh shit, that'll still fucking take 4 seconds. Never mind. Talk to
it's
you.
Mizuki.
Okay. What option should we do here? Slap her, hug her, make her laugh, smile at her. What would she want? I make her laugh, I guess?
I will imitate you, Date. Aw, whittle mini lightbulb needs a change. Oh, good boy. Mini, mini, mini. Okay, cutie little mini lightbulb. I'll turn you on. Yes, I will. Ah, you turned on. Good job, mini lightbulb. Mini, mini, mini.
I never said that before.
I have no idea what the fuck is going on. Bitch, what is happening?
No reaction.
Because it doesn't make any sense.
God!
No good.
Damn, we didn't make it.
All of our work has been undone by a simple question. Fuck it. Fuck it, keep retrying from the spot. We're so close. We're so fucking close. Simple.
There are torn pieces of...
We simply piece these together. But not after applying that. Piece it together. Hold, skip. It's all good. Mashing this button. Cut it into a third. Stop it. All right. We're so close. Now we just run inside. Do you think there's anything we do? There is one thing I didn't try with you. Pretty sure I never talked to this thing, so I will. Bop, bop.
Excuse me, but do you happen to know the culprit? I see.
Did you learn something?
I did. Beyond a shadow of a doubt.
Well?
This horse cannot speak English.
We were so close.
1 minute. Hurry.
It's Mizuki.
I'll try. Okay, we know make her laugh doesn't work. So what we'll do is we'll cut this into a 7. And we shall hug her. Yeah, that's the good choice, I guess.
Mizuki.
That's it! That was a useful few minutes. Are you
okay?
Date. Date!
Looks like she can talk again.
After she calmed down, I asked her a few questions. Asked her about last night, about the Nile message, about Ota, and about Shoko. I know that after Ota ran off, something must have happened to make Mizuki want to hide. How you doing?
I told you I'm fine. So annoying.
I annoyed you already, huh?
The pressure is annoying.
What pressure?
Force over area measured in pascals, dummy.
I see she is back to her usual self. Her attitude is within normal parameters.
I think I liked her better when she was silent.
You know what? I agree. You want a sandwich?
I'm fine now, but I didn't forget your promise.
A promise?
Stew? You said you'd take me.
So you heard that, huh?
Aphonia only affects speech. Her hearing should still be intact.
Sure, Mizuki. When we're all done here.
Alright, who sent the message?
I can't tell you.
Why not?
Because I don't want to.
That's not a reason. You were at the scene of the crime because of that Nile message. Whoever sent it to you is a prime suspect.
I don't think she is going to answer. When she is in a mood, it's impossible to get her to talk. That's the kind of girl she is.
Sometimes I think you know her better than I do.
How long do you think I've been observing her?
It's been 4 years now.
Correct. I know things that even you do not know.
Like? Actually, never mind. Some things I'm better off not knowing.
By the way, we already looked into Mizuki's cell phone. Unfortunately, the contents were wiped.
I'm tracing the sender of the Nile message through other means, but it's taking me some time.
About that figure I saw.
Say, Mizuki, who is that figure I saw?
What?
Insomnia, in your dream. I saw a silhouette.
Date, Mizuki would not understand the question. She does not experience somnium as you do. You are witnessing a dream inside her brain.
Never mind. Did you see anyone at the merry-go-round the night you found Shoko?
I did. I saw someone in the corner, past the merry-go-round.
Who did you see?
I don't know. It was dark and raining. They looked scary, so I hid inside the merry-go-round. The door was open a little bit, so I snuck in.
Yeah, this is not a good time for her. How about you guys? Who do you think the suspect is?
Peter, who do you think the culprit is?
Well, let's see. Perhaps it was you, Special Agent Darty.
What?
I'm kidding.
Just having a little bit of fun? About the figure.
No, that. I saw it too.
Who or what do you think it was?
Most likely someone Mizuki saw in person projected into her subconscious. Dreams can only be constructed from images and experiences the subject was present for. Mizuki's somnium couldn't have contained that figure if she didn't see it in person. Of course, not everything we see in our dreams looks exactly the same as it did in the real world. You saw some strange things in Somnium earlier, didn't you, Date? That event you experienced is obviously not as it happened in reality. Dreams are a collage of many memories, intertwining and blending with each other. Your skills as a synker allow you to untangle those dreams and solve mysteries no one else can.
About Somnium.
In a normal dream, the person experiencing the dream cannot remove themselves from it. Dreams are first-person experiences. However, the circumstances are slightly different during a sync. The syncer dives into the subject's mind and experiences their subconscious thoughts. But this dream is experienced as an observer, as though you were watching a play. The subject is the author, director, and actor. The synker is merely the audience.
How does Iba appear in Somnium?
Iba is linked to your brain with an artificial nerve. To put it more simply, Iba is a part of your brain. During syncing, your consciousness is sent into the subject's somnium. Part of Iba's self is also synced, but only a part. Not all of Iba's functions are transferred into somnium.
So that's why Somnium Iba is so dumb.
I agree.
Don't call me dumb.
About Iba's appearance.
Hey, Pewter. When we were in Somnium earlier, Iba was in human form. She's never looked like that before.
That was Iba's idea.
What?
I thought you would be more pleased. I designed it to your taste.
What part of that was my taste?
I know everything inside your mind. You don't have to hide it.
Computer, Iba's broken. She's talking crazy.
I am not broken.
Perhaps Iba admires the human form.
It's not that. It was just a little something. I consider Kaname Date to be my host. I owe him gratitude. I simply thought that appearance would make him happy.
Why would that make me happy?
Well, let's move on to you. Any questions?
Right, there was something. Hey, Mizuki, when we found you, you were holding the ice pick, right? Can you tell us why?
When I got there, the ice pick was... It was stuck in my mom's eye. I couldn't think straight. The only thing I could think was... I had to get it out.
So you panicked and pulled it out?
Yeah.
And you held on to it when you hid in the column?
Yeah.
Okay, just one more question. This is very important. When you pulled out the ice pick, was Shoko's eye still there?
I'm pretty sure it wasn't.
The eye socket was empty.
Yeah.
Thank you, Mizuki. That was very helpful.
Boss shines in moments like this. She doesn't hesitate to ask anything.
Now we know that Mizuki did not remove the victim's eye.
When we got to the scene, it was definitely missing.
And it has not yet been recovered. We can therefore conclude it has been removed from the scene.
About what I saw in Somnium.
No need to report specifics. We saw it all from here in the control room. What the Sinker sees in Somnium is projected here, remember? We've got it all recorded.
Isn't it incredible? I invented it.
Anyway, we know about the figure you saw. I wonder who that could be.
Summarize for me.
Anyway, I get the story. Mizuki witnessed a suspicious person at the scene, but she didn't get a good look at them.
Maybe there's something at the scene we missed. Date, could you return to the scene of the crime? There might be more to Bloom Park than we first thought.
About her muteness.
Yeah, I'm glad she's talking again. You healed the wounds in her heart by syncing with her. Well, you meaning you and Iba.
The boss has extraordinary perception. I deserve much of the credit for helping Mizuki recover her voice.
All you did was follow my instructions.
Date, Mizuki needs you. Protect her.
And thoughts on the suspect.
How would I know? We still don't have enough information. Continue your investigation, Special Agent.
All right, time to head out back to Bloom Park. Why do I think this is loading? I'm just sitting here and just perfectly content, like, we'll just wait. Oh, good, we brought her with us.
Somewhere around here, right?
Yep.
Let's see. Past the bush. Figure went that way. A bench. Another bench. A Goral. About that suspicious figure.
You saw that person standing here, right? A man?
Yeah.
What was he doing?
I don't know, it was dark. But I think he was watching me. He was standing there in the rain with no umbrella. But I don't remember anything else. I got scared and went to hide inside the column.
You remember anything?
Yeah, I do.
What do you remember?
I went to this amusement park when I was little. I was 4. I remember it so clearly. This is where I saw my mom and dad smile. I had so many happy memories here. The only happy memories I really have are from here. Memories of my family are so bright and colorful. But now, this is where Mom...
What's wrong?
Nothing. Just wondering where this goes.
Iba, what's past here?
This leads to the subway.
A subway?
It has, of course, closed down. It is no longer in service. This is due to the explosion at the chemical plant that occurred years ago. The surrounding district of Kawasaki was contaminated and declared off-limits. Bloom Park closed for the same reason, as did all commerce and industry in Kawasaki. This means the railroads and public transportation to and from this area were shut down as well.
The subway. Iba, does the entire track run underground?
No. The track leading northward from Bloom Park eventually rises to ground level.
At a railroad crossing?
Correct.
Then the tracks must cross a surface street at some point.
Correct.
Alright.
Iba, do me a favor. Can you see if any cars were driving on that surface street last night?
Searching.
Hey, you've been quiet for a long time. Are you okay?
I'm just thinking.
I've got something. I picked up a single vehicle traversing that street last night. A black SUV. I ran the plate through the vehicle registration database to find the owner.
Who was it?
Shoko Nadami's ex-husband and Mizuki's father, Renju Okiura.
And we drive.
So let me get this straight. You think that Daddy drove his car on the tracks through the tunnel, stopped at the closed down station, and carried Mom's body to the park?
I can't prove it was Renju. There's a chance someone else was driving the car.
Yeah. Yeah.
But, in any case, I know that the suspect must have used the subway tracks. That explains why there were no cars parked near the scene. Using that subway station, could take the body right to the merry-go-round without being caught on camera.
Daddy didn't do it.
I am not so certain.
Either way, I have to talk to Renju, and you can help me find him.
Well, I guess we should chat then. About the Nile message.
Mizuki, Renju sent you that Nile message, didn't he?
What?
I got this buddy of mine. Real bad personality, but real good with technology. I got some help from them.
Bad personality?
It was a message sent at 8:05 last night. Does it sound familiar? Mizuki, Daddy got caught up in something serious. Please come to Bloom Park's merry-go-round right away. Daddy needs your help. Please do as I say.
Yeah, that was it. It was from Daddy's phone. But I didn't want to say anything because that would make Daddy a suspect, so...
So you kept quiet?
Yeah. My dad's never said anything like that to me, ever. That he was counting on me? I had to go.
But you invited Ota along.
Bloom Park is in the middle of the Kawasaki district. There are a number of homeless individuals in a high crime rate there. Mizuki must have been worried about going alone.
But it couldn't be him.
Why not?
Daddy couldn't have sent the message. Someone else must have used his phone. And his car. Daddy wasn't driving the car either. Somebody else did it. The killer did it, not Daddy.
The only evidence we have so far leads to one conclusion. The cell phone and the car were both operated by Renju Okiura.
It's not looking good so far. You look like you want to speak up.
I don't want to say anything.
Oh, okay, never mind.
To you.
Sorry.
I don't want to talk to anyone who thinks my daddy is a killer.
Okay.
Look, I don't want to believe it either. I've known him for more than 5 years now. He's like family to me.
Never want to put cuffs on him. Never wanted Mizuki to see that either. Anyway, Renju just isn't the type of guy to commit a crime. When was the last time you saw Daddy?
I think about a week ago. When I went to hang out at Lemniscate.
Did you notice anything different about him?
Nothing really. He was the same as usual.
And he didn't come to see you in the hospital, did he?
No.
Not even for his own daughter.
That is very unusual.
Yeah, very weird that he shows up, does his interview, leaves, doesn't see his daughter once. When was the last time you spoke continued?
I don't remember. It was a while ago. What about you?
What about me?
You tried calling him.
I did. I called earlier, and I tried a few times last night.
And he didn't pick up?
No.
Incoming call from the boss.
Connected.
Moshi Moshi.
Hey, I just got the report from Ima. Renju is a suspect?
He's definitely suspicious.
I agree. I think he's our number one suspect. He's been acting strange since last night. He didn't come see Mizuki in the hospital, won't pick up his phone, and he vanishes after questioning. He doesn't have an alibi for the time of the murder either.
He doesn't?
No, not one we can corroborate.
About Renju's alibi.
Shoko's time of death was estimated to be about 5 p.m. yesterday. Renju claims that he was at home alone at the time, but that means no one can back up his story.
About his questioning.
He didn't give us any new information. He didn't have much to say at all, frankly.
Any idea where he is?
No, I told you he vanished. Where are you heading?
Renju's house.
Don't bother. I had local cops search the place. I didn't find anything.
Where could he be?
Why did you release him?
So Renju was questioned at a local station?
That's right.
Then why didn't you keep him there?
Protocol. Nothing we could do. He wasn't a suspect then, and we had nothing to charge him with. We couldn't hold him.
That's not great. So it's streaming in a call to his eye. That's... just no need for a cell phone, though. I'm a hang up now. I gotta go.
All right, boss. Let me know if you find something.
You too. Keep me in the loop.
Where the hell did Renju go?
Sunpoke?
What?
Sunpoke. Or something.
Oh, Sunfish Pocket. Renju was telling me about that place. It's a maid cafe that he runs.
I found it. Approximately 6.2 miles north-northeast in Akihabara.
It's worth a try. Thanks for watching. My videos are not possible without the generous support of people over on my Patreon. You're seeing their names go across the screen right now. Of course, we have to give some special props to some of the higher tiered patrons, and I'm going to do so now. They include people such as the Wayfinders, such as Losky3, DronicLX, Sheep Heavenly, Mr. I Like Bacon, Javier Pork Sword, Haas Bear, Ed Rodriguez, Matthew Cassidy, Jordan Pastrana, and Azure Counselor. But standing even above them as my ultimate supporters, the organization, the highest tier, includes Kristen Cervantes, Grim Reaper, and Colleen Suarez. Thank you so much to the people who support me over on patreon.com/KZExcellent. If you want your name featured, head on over to the Patreon link in the description and consider supporting and checking out the various perks. Thanks again, and I'll see you next time.